What is up, guys? I'm back again with another video. In today's one, what we're going to do is we'll be discussing about various tips, tricks, and methods you can use to create digital art using a mouse coming up. So before starting off with the video, a quick disclaimer that this video will include various theoretical points, and if you want to know how you can actually practically apply them in your software, whether you are using Krita, GIMP, Photoshop, I will be providing links as well as annotations in between of this video whenever I will be mentioning those points. So yeah, with that said, let's get into the video. So starting off with the first point, which is obviously using reference sketches and concept arts. You might have heard about this point like million times, because this is so basic, yet people just simply forget about this, especially whenever they're working with mouse. When you're working with a drawing tablet, it is much more easier to lay down a basic foundation through sketching before starting off with the main line artwork. But whenever you're working with a mouse, you cannot draw those precise, pressure sensitive lines, which you can do with an active or passive stylus. So if you want a reference art, you can use Google or Pinterest for that. And in case you want a basic concept art for your image or a basic sketch foundation on which you can lay down your line artwork, what you can do is you can make a basic sketch on a paper, click a photo of it, import it to your PC, then open it in your software, whatever sort of software you're using, Krita, GIMP or Photoshop, and just make a simple basic sort of line art out of it. I've already made a video on this topic. If you want to check it out, the link will be in the description, as well as I will be making a screen card or annotation, whatever you call it. So coming up to the next point, line smoothing. The problem of not getting smooth lines will just ruin the entire experience of you using a mouse for drawing stuff. It makes the entire process much more tedious and time consuming. So in order to avoid this, in order to fix it, what you can do is avoid this problem. Every software has their own version of this brush stabilization tool. Like in Krita, we have two versions of this. The first one is a freehand path tool, and the second one is a simple brush stabilization. So as you can see over here, if I try to draw with a simple normal brush, it provides me a very jittery and shaky sort of line, not at all professional. Now we jump onto the freehand path tool and we try to draw these curved lines. And as you can see, it just modifies the lines a little bit and makes them precise, smooth and pretty clear. Similarly, if I try to use a brush stabilization tool and try to draw something with it, it adds a mass or sort of a drag to my brush stroke, and it makes us draw much more precise, much more crisp and clear lines. And in case you're coming from GIMP or Photoshop or any other software, I'll be providing respective links to the videos where you can find a similar sort of brush stabilization tool and you can use it to make smooth and clear line strokes. However, there is a universal technique which applies to every software, no matter what software you're using, for creating smoother lines, which is actually to make faster gestures or faster strokes. The faster your mouse moves, the less shake and jerk it registers, and hence the smoother the lines will be. And similarly, vice versa. Coming to the next point, which is optimizing your art style. Drawing with a mouse is not that easy as it seems to be very fair. Just look at this painting. Can you make this painting with the mouse? Well, some can, but not everybody. Or even if you can draw this, the process will be really lengthy and very time consuming. Therefore, whenever you're using a mouse to make artwork, try to restrict your art style a little bit. Try to go for a much more flatter sort of art style. Go for a cartoonic art style, minimalist, flat, vector, or even pixelated art style. Especially pixels. They are really great for animations as well as game development, so you can use that as well. The last one is learn to be more patient. Let's be real here, guys. Drawing with the mouse is really time consuming and will definitely take a test of your patience and sanity. So make sure to keep a cold coffee by your side and your Spotify playlist ready to play before starting hustling with long art sessions. So yeah, that was the video, guys. As I said before, these points are just theoreticals. If you want the practical explanation, how you can actually perform these things, your line smoothing, your brush stabilization, importing of your concept art, all of that cool stuff, you can watch the videos. The links will be in the description. I actually didn't go for that practical approach in this video because that would have made this video an hour or 2 hour long, which I didn't intend it to. So yeah, you can comment down if you have any video ideas, comments or suggestions. I'll see you guys next time. Until then, peace.